everyone, and welcome to the Bong Wanderers channel. Today is 31st May. The Bong Wanderers are at Vizag. If you have been following us, you saw in the last vlog that we drove down to Vizag from Kolkata yesterday. Almost a 15 hours drive.
It was 15 hours. Yeah. 15 hours.
15 hours drive. And I mean, we didn't realize the exhaustion at that point. I think after I woke up today, I can see the exhaustion. So which is why, I mean, it was a planned break. We decided to take a break today at Vizag and just rest. If our body permits, then probably we'll just check out some places nearby. We are staying at the Bhimli Resort this time. So last time when we were going to Kolkata, we stayed at the park, Vishakhapatnam. This time we decided to stay at the Bhimli Resort, and I think we are very happy with the decision that we took. It's 10:30 in the morning. Bong's having breakfast. I've almost finished my breakfast. I'm having my kappa.
For a change, I am having.
Mr. Banerjee is finishing his puri and sabzi, but he needs food and rest today, because tomorrow again we will be covering another fairly large distance from Vishakhapatnam to Hyderabad. So yeah, I mean, today's vlog will be mostly about the Bhimli Resort and also some places in and around Bhimli Resort. Hope you will enjoy the vlog and Vishakhapatnam through our eyes. Okay, so this is the view you get at the break at their all-day dining place in the morning. So you can literally have food by the sea and in a conducive environment, because it's indoor and in AC. So it's a beautiful view. Let me show you more. That's the view that welcomes you from their all-day dining restaurant. I mean, what else you want? So they have some indoor games placed in their all-day dining place. You can see the fuse ball. This is almost a hit in Bong Wanderers. We are crazy about this game. Right now, two Bong Wanderers battling it out. I mean, any guesses who is winning? Breakfast done. We are back to our room, and this is the view from the balcony. Bhimli Beach behind me, and it's very clean and very nicely decorated. You know, we are planning to go to the beach, so we'll give you glimpses of the beach. But seriously, even if you don't want to go to the beach, you don't need to. You can just sit in your balcony and enjoy the view. Okay, right now, our Fadi baby is in the balcony, and see how she reacts to the drone.
Angel, come here. Angel, come here. Yeah, yeah. Angel, yeah.
We are trying to. We are trying to make her adjusted to the drone, because every time we are trying to fly the drone, she freaks out. So the papa is trying to make her daughter strong by making her used to the drone. Look at her condition. Inju, drone.
The baboons are still hogging, this time on, what are you having? Sandwich.
Club chicken sandwich.
Okay, I did not have much. I only had a popsicle, and I am ready. Who was telling me that I overate my breakfast?
We had a okay breakfast. Yeah.
After eating everything that was available in the breakfast, they had an okay breakfast. Anyways, that's the story. Having lunch, then we are off to some nearby places. Let's see where we can go. We will keep you posted. For now, let them enjoy their lunch.
On our way to a very interesting destination. Last time we wanted to visit that place, but we couldn't because of time. So now we are heading to Tenety Park. It is approximately 20 minutes of drive from this place. 30 minutes of drive from Bhimli. And this is the view.
So Tenety Park is in Vizag.
Okay. And we are right now at Bhimli.
Bhimli, which is about 30 kilometers from Vizag.
Okay. So Bhimli is not actually in Vizag. It is a different place.
Bhimapattinam is the name of the place.
Okay. And we see a beautiful temple, which will be coming up on your screen right now. It's a beautiful temple. Look at the color. Okay, so not very sure how many people know about this place, Bhimli, where we are staying. Sure, many come and stay at Bhimli Resort. It's quite a popular resort.
But it might be localites or nearby people know, but it has a beautiful history that should be told.
So what's the history?
Bhimli is not actually the name. Bhimli is the name given by the Britishers. Oh. The actual name was and is for locals is Bhimapattinam or something like that. I'm probably not pronouncing it correctly. It was first inhabited by the or made famous by the Dutch settlements. So the Dutch people came here, found out it to be a great port away from Vizag, which was by then taken by Britishers, and they started inhabiting this place, creating it as a port, their main port, Dutch main port. Their,
look at the view colonies. Here. I'm so sorry to interrupt you. Look at the view. There's so many people over here. Okay, looks like this is a famous spot.
It's a Coco Arena Beach.
Coco Arena Beach. Ah, it's a beautiful spot. Beautiful. Please continue.
So, the Dutch. What will I continue? See the views there. Oh, beautiful. So, the Dutch settled down here. And they started developing the place. Even today, there is a monument that has been erected in the in the name of the Dutch, and they have a Dutch memorial, they have a Dutch cemetery, and a lot of sculptures and statues in their name. So it has its own
charm,
remembrance and charm, yes,
and legacy. And the beach is very clean.
Yeah, very, very clean.
Very, very clean.
I saw this morning they were cleaning the beach.
Yeah. And last time we actually stayed at proper Vizag. And the beach is so dirty over there.
See this.
Oh, wow. Wow. Just wow. What is this place? It's beautiful. We are at a beautiful place. I mean, this is just a deserted place on our way to Vizag from Bhimli. And it's quite a beautiful place. You can stop by and click some pictures, soak in the beauty, sense the crowd, absorb it all. It's a beautiful spot. Driving by the beautiful Bay of Bengal and just can't get over the view. this is a drive you must take. Even if you are staying at Vizag, come for a drive to Bhimli. That is also something that will give you a lot of happiness. So many boats over here. Wow.
Here is where the boating happens.
No, I don't think. These are fishermen boats. Fishermen's boats. These are all fishermen boats. So we drove, we were on this road almost 2 years back. In the middle of the night, we hardly
almost
enjoyed. More than 2 years back. We were actually coming here pretty late in the night. तो भगवान ने बोला बेटा इतने सुंदर हमने दुनिया बनाया तुम लोगों ने देखा ही नहीं ठीक से कोई बात नहीं फिर से तुम लोगों को इधर लेके आएंगे हम तब देखना
सुंदर दुनिया में सुंदर सुंदर सांड जा रहा है
अरे
सांड नहीं क्या बोलते इसको बफेलो बफेलो
वो भी तो भगवान का बनाया हुआ ही है ना
लाइक अस का हिंदी क्या है
बफेलो का हिंदी भैंस भैंस व्हाट आर बफेलोस ये भी तो उनका दुनिया हमारा भी जितना है जितना हमारी दुनिया है उतना ही उनका उनका भी दुनिया है राइट एंड मे बी दिस आई मीन दिस वाज एक्चुअली देयर प्लेस वी हैव इनहैबिटेड इनटू देयर प्लेस केयरफुल पापा लुक एट दिस रोड सो ब्यूटीफुल
So we are driving from Bhimli to Vizag and we are discovering new things on the way. Always read it in terms of reports, articles. But this is something that got to see right now. This is called as a natural arch. So there are rocky formations which over the time because of waves and wind have broken and carved out of these rocks. Into natural arches below which water actually gushes in through the waves and then gushes out. It looks beautiful.
Can you see that? Where I'm pointing the finger. So you see the waves coming in. Now you wait for it. Yeah, did you just see water popping up? So that's the like bubbles. There you go. That's the place where the natural arch has been created. Beautiful point, by the way, for you to stop by, take pictures, spend some good time. So do visit this place if you can.
You must.
Huh?
You must.
You must, huh?
Natural
yeah.
beauty.
Yeah. See, all of us are enjoying fresh air and the smell of the sea and the beauty.
हर दूरियां हर फासले करीब हैं इस उम्र की भी शख्सियत अजीब है झीनी झीनी इन सांसों से पहचानी सी आवाजों कैसे हम बेजुबान इस जीने में कहीं हम भी थे ज्यादा या जरा कम ही थे रुक के भी चल पड़े मगर रस्ते सब बेजुबान
Sea viewpoint. There is a pool somewhere here which is called the dolphin pool.
Okay. Pretty.
Oh, it looks nice.
Yeah, pretty windy, but the beach is beautiful and it's quite a touristy spot. We saw a lot of people over here, so you can come here, click a lot of pictures and enjoy now.
So this is the ship called MV Ma from Bangladesh. In 2020, Amphan cyclone, it actually wandered off the coast of Bangladesh and reached India, somewhere near Vizag. It was wandering in the Indian waters near to Vizag. In 2021, the Indian government approved the owners of the ship to be towed away to Bangladesh. However, after doing the math, the owners figured out that the cost of towing this vessel to their homeland would be much more expensive than the price of the ship itself. And that's when they actually left it abandoned. The local authorities seized the opportunity and made it as a tourist spot where lots of tourists visit every day to take a view of this beautiful ship, or beautiful view of a ship on the docks.
Okay, saw a beautiful mermaid statue on the beach, and this beach is quite popular. Look at the crowd, it's filled with people. Has just become a celebrity at the beach. Angel has clearly become a celebrity again. So found some very cute stuff on this beach, like this beautiful five monks sitting over here.
Should I tell you a fun fact?
Yeah.
Buddha was the only monk who had a hair, because not all monks have hair.
Okay, so five monks and a dog. A tall fisherman stands confidently on Bhimli Beach, reminding us of the people who are absolutely necessary in our lives. And these are the people who keep places like this alive. This is an arrangement of dolphin with a croc sitting on the top. I mean, it's quite a vibrant park they have created over here. It's just that it's a bit crowded, so you can preferably come early morning. There's this lighthouse. I love Bhimli. Beach walk done. Now we are sitting in their outside garden area, which is beautifully lit up. A little hot because of the humidity and temperature, but still, nevertheless, I think the view inside and outside compensates for it. It's also their high tea area. They have an outdoor and indoor arrangement. We can't sit indoor because of Angel, but thankfully she is allowed in the garden. So, thoda chai pi lete, aur fir we'll head back to room, do some packing for tomorrow, and then have our dinner.
आओ हमारे होटल में चाय पियो जी गरम गरम, बिस्कुट खा लो नरम नरम, जो दिल चाहे मांग लो हमसे, सब कुछ है भगवान कसम भगवान कसम। आओ हमारे होटल में चाय पियो जी गरम गरम।
It's 9:30. We are back in our room, and both of us are standing in the balcony and just absorbing the
summer
view.
Chronicles ends here. Tomorrow is the last day.
Yeah,
it was quite a long one.
Yeah.
Though it was not a vacation, it was mostly personal work.
We had some
reasons,
work in
health
Bangalore,
reasons for which we had to
travel
to Kolkata.
Yeah, family members' health reasons.
But we
made
a vacation out of it, right? Though we were working, we made a vacation out of it. We relished the journey, we planned new routes.
We met few friends, both in Bangalore as well as in Kolkata. In between, you know, we took a pit stop at Chennai, and it was a weekend. So that was a little bit of vacation for us at Fisherman's Cove. We had a wonderful time over there. And then while coming back from Kolkata to Vizag, we stayed. Oh no, while going to Kolkata also, we stayed one day at Vizag.
We roamed around Kailasagiri.
Yeah, we went to different places.
You have already seen that vlog.
Right. and this vlog. So these two vlogs should give you a good idea about the places that you can visit at Vizag.
Yeah.
And trust me, I don't know. I mean, this is our personal opinion. Maybe people already know. But we feel Vizag is really an underrated spot. Because it's beautiful. I mean, beautiful in terms of its natural beauty, not artificial beauty.
And it's maintained very well. So
maintained very well. Roads
so
are very clean.
So the local authorities have been doing a fantastic job, is what I should tell. Very well maintained. It feels good to be in this city. It's very vibrant. People are
very good.
Very vibrant. Very good.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean. Two-wheelers, wherever you go in India, is a menace. It's very much here, but people are very good. Local authorities have done beautiful job.
Roads are clean.
Roads are clean and good condition. And the sheer idea of that ship being turned from an abandoned vessel into a tourist spot is a beautiful idea. So, a big thumbs up from us, from the Bang Wanderers to Vizag. And we'll be coming
please
back soon.
Please do visit Vizag if you haven't. I know that there's a lot of craze about Goa and other beaches, but this is a place, guys. I mean, this is
especially so Bhimli Beach.
Especially Bhimli Beach.
It's very clean.
Very clean, and it has its own natural charm, and overall Vizag.
So even Rishikonda Beach that you saw was very clean.
And the beauty is that you will find different places to go, right? I mean, this place will definitely need at least 2 full days, if not more, right? Of course, you can spend one more day to relax, but at least 2 full days to explore all the places.
Chalo, on that note then.
We are going to come back to this place again for sure, and we are going to spend more time in future.
On that note, bye-bye, take care. Tomorrow's vlog you will get to see in another 5-10 days. Till then, take care, bye bye. Do subscribe, like, share and subscribe. Tell your friends about us, and watch our videos to know lots about road trips, travel with your pets and pet friendly stays. Bye bye.
Bye bye, take care.